We bless the name of the Lord for yet another beautiful week, a glorious day and a glorious moment. The Lord is good indeed. We are still dealing with our giving series. We are on our giving series and it's been wonderful. I've learned so much. The Lord has been dealing with my heart in many ways. And I know the Lord has been dealing with your heart and the Lord is improving your giving grace and your giving spirit. Father, as we share your word, let your spirit descend upon our lives and bring us to the place where our eyes will be open, light will be thrown, illumination, understanding, proper application of your word, and may we experience the power thereof. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Today, I'm talking about giving that makes you a memorial. Giving that makes you a memorial. And we'll be looking at Matthew chapter 26, verse 6 to 13. Matthew chapter 26, verses 6 to 13. We know the story of the woman that broke the alabaster box. For the Bible made reference to him as the Mary who broke the alabaster box. Now, what does it mean? It means that we have different kinds of giving. We have different kinds of giving in this life. Different kinds of giving under the sun. And one of such giving is a giving that makes you a memorial. Now, what is a memorial giving? A memorial giving is that giving that can never die away. In other words, when you launch into a memorial giving or became a memorial giver, you may be dead and be buried, but your story, your act, will always make you alive. Like Abel, who gave, died, yet his voice is still speaking, and God is always testifying of his giving. So a memorial giving can never die away. Number two, a memorial giving captures the totality of the receiver. A memorial giving captures the totality of the receiver. We'll see from the passage very shortly that when the woman gave to Jesus, she captured every part of Jesus. Thirdly, a giving that is transgenerational. A memorial giving is a transgenerational giving. In other words, it is a giving that outlives the giver. It's a giving that goes beyond the giver. It's a giving that affects generations to come. So a memorial giving is a transgenerational giving. It is also a monumental and commemorative giving. When you give memorially, you are giving a monumental giving. A monumental giving and a commemorative giving. Now I want us to glean the passage. Matthew chapter 26 verse 6 to 13. I want us to glean it. There are 8 things that I want to bring to your notice. The first thing is found in verses 6 to verse 7. Verses 6 to 7 of Matthew 26. Giving, it's a giving by seizing the moment or opportunity. A memorial giving is a giving that one gives by seizing the moment, seizing the opportunity. The woman was not invited even to attend that function where Jesus was invited by Simon the leper. But the woman found herself there. She saw that the feet of Jesus was not washed. She saw that Simon was so busy, he couldn't provide even the traditional things every Jew provide at home. So the woman had to cry, produce even tears for water to wash the feet of Jesus. She produced her hair for towel to wipe away and to wipe the wetness. And then she broke the alabaster box, the perfume over the head of Jesus. So it is a giving that we give by seizing a moment. So sometimes God brings us into a situation. We see an occasion. We come into a need. We see an opportunity. Let's seize the moment, because that can be a memorial giving. Number two, we can find that in verse 7b. 7b. A memorial giving is a giving by placing high value on the receiver. Memorial givings are givings that are given by placing a high value on the receiver. If you do not place a high value on the receiver, it will be difficult to do a memorial giving. The Bible says that she broke a precious ointment. She broke a precious, costly, expensive ointment. If she did not value Jesus, she wouldn't have broken that alabaster box. Number three, it is a giving by ignoring critics. Memorial giving is a giving that ignores critics. In verses 8, people criticize the woman. People criticize the woman. As for the Pharisees, they saw the woman as a sinner. And they said, if this is a prophet and she knows who is touching her, he will not even allow. The disciples of Jesus accused the woman of waste when Jesus saw worship. So if you want to give a giving that will outlive you, you must ignore your critics. Because people will criticize you. People will judge you. People will say all kinds of things about your giving. But you got to ignore your critics. Number four, a memorial giving is a giving that must not be trivialized. Verse 9, we must never trivialize it. The disciples trivialized the giving of the woman. They say she's wasting this giving. She's wasting the oil. How can you walk with Jesus? How can you value a master? And when somebody is actually appraising or praising or adoring your master, you call it a waste. A memorial giving is a giving that must not be trivialized. Must never trivialize it. Number five. We can find that in verse 10. It's a giving that is considered good. The word good here is the word valuable, virtuous, distinguished, something that stands out. Jesus said, she has done a distinguished thing. What she has done for me stands out among all the things that I've ever received. Her act stands out. So a memorial giving is considered a good thing. So let us learn to give a memorial giving. Number six, a memorial giving, they are very rare. Memorial givings are rare. It's a giving that is very rare. They don't normally often happen. They are so rare. They are just so rare. We can't find many of such even in the Bible. So they are so rare. That is why when you see the opportunity to give memorially, it is like finding gold or finding a precious metal. Of buying a land and you know, or discovering a land has precious metal in it, you go sell all you have to go and buy that land. It is very rare. It's a memorial opportunity, don't happen always. Such opportunities don't happen always. Number seven, memorial giving is a giving that is deep. Verse 12, it's a very deep giving. Jesus said, this woman has been loved deeply, so she has also acted out of love that is deep. Memorial givings are deep. Jesus said, what she has done, she has prepared me, she has prepared my body for my burial. This act of giving, she has actually done to prepare my body. That is why on the day of the resurrection of Jesus, the three women were denied opportunity to demonstrate their tradition. A memorial giving can buy out people out of their tradition. You may give now and buy people out of what they should have done tomorrow or what they ought to do tomorrow. And that's what this Mary did. She bought the three women out of their resurrection preparation of the body of Jesus. She prepared the body of Jesus in advance. As the Lord calls you to give to him memorially, please do everything to do it. It doesn't matter how much it costs. It doesn't matter how expensive that act will be. Do it, because you may be buying some people out of their place and you will be occupying it. Jesus even said, Anywhere that this woman, I mean, the gospel is preached, let the woman's act also be mentioned. So it is deep. She prepared the body of Jesus for a burial. Number 8. A memorial giving is a giving that carries a perpetual voice. Jesus said, what she has done will match the gospel. Today, I'm still talking about what the woman did. Jesus said, for anywhere the gospel will be preached, let the act of this woman be mentioned. So as long as Jesus is preached, as long as the resurrection message go, this woman's act of giving memorially can never die. What it means is that she actually brought herself by this act into the resurrection life of Christ because she gave memorially. Verse 13. We can find that in verse 13. In conclusion, memorial giving is a selfless giving, but it is self-defense. In conclusion, memorial giving is a selfless giving, but it is also your self-defense. In other words, memorial giving defends you, protects you into the future. Today, the Lord is calling us to give unto him, to make our giving a memorial before the Lord, a giving that will not die away, a giving that will outlive us, a giving that is transgenerational. And we pray that God will give us the grace to open our eyes when we see the opportunity to give memorially, that we will not miss our moment and miss our time. Father, I pray, even for the grace of God, even that comes upon people, that give them the grace to see the opportunities and to give according to memorial. I also pray for those who have given givens, who do not even know how they did it or what they have done, but they are memorial givens. Today, as they hear the sound of my voice, we declare an activation of the voice of their memorial giving and let their memorial speak for them. We thank you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ that you give us the grace to ignore our critics and those who criticize us when we give a memorial giving by divine instruction and by the leading of the Spirit. May your name be praised today and may your name be glorified. We thank you, Lord. We exhort you because you are awesome in Jesus' name. If you want to receive Jesus, even today, I want you to pray this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I give you my heart. I receive you as the Son of God. I acknowledge I'm a sinner. Come be and live in my heart. Come and be my King, my Lord, and my personal Savior. I surrender to you fully. Have your way in my life in Jesus' name. If you pray this prayer, you have become a son and a bona fide member of the kingdom. God bless you. I come to you tomorrow with another message on giving. We will never be the same again because this is our month of harvest and our season of harvest. That is why God is calling us to give. God bless you. This is your beloved pastor and friend, Shamosin Gloriabe, bringing you the Mega Breath Devotional. Mega Shalom. I love you, and I'll see you again tomorrow. Be blessed. Amen.